When we engaged care for Grandma Holly, we saw curious behaviors in even our closest loved ones, nonstop status updates, well wishes, and everyone asking how they could help.
Our hospice provider told us how a care community might help our loved ones stay more comfortably connected around Holly, Grandpa Jim, and the rest of us. They were spot on.
Creating the care community was simple and took just 5 minutes. It was easy for us all to see how everyone's interactions became more natural. Jim even commented how great it made Holly feel, seeing everyone stop trying so hard to not intrude.
The iHelp calendar in our care community made it easier and more natural to organize activities, including games of bridge, movie nights, coffees, and music therapy. Help from loved ones with errands, meals, and tasks became so much easier. We no longer felt we were intruding in everyone's busy lives.
Social storytelling was nothing short of a miracle to Holly and Jim. 20 times every day, they laughed until they cried, reliving memories like Holly's first kiss, learning to roller skate, her senior prom, and Jim's proposal. What's most amazing are the variety of stories relived through everyone's photos and in their own voices.
Numerous discussions ongoing in the Care Community blog continue moving us away from well wishes and sympathy, more toward empathy. It continues to amaze us how engaged the younger members of our family and distant loved ones are in celebrating and rallying around Holly and Jim.
It was impossible not to see the impact our care community had on Grandma Holly's peace of mind and on Grandpa Jim's outlook and resilience.
Holly's memorial was unlike other family losses. Frowns became smiles. The way we stayed close around Holly have carried over for months around Jim's life and activities, like walks in the park, bingo games, and sports on TV, simply through the love and engagement of our care community.